Hello friends, so welcome to my channel once again. Did you have a fear of missing out on my new video? Just kidding. So in this video we'll continue with the previous part where we stopped. So we saw in our previous video how batteries are costing, like how much it would cost a battery in electric vehicle, and how we can reduce that cost, and what all are the advantages of having an in-house manufacturing capacity, and how this is the sector that you should be investing in from today or from this year, so that if you want huge returns in long run. So if you have not watched that video, please watch that video. Now let's see what all are the needs of government, like Indian needs. So it's estimated that by 2022 we'll need 10 gigawatt hour of battery capacity. So 1 gigawatt hour is sufficient to run million houses and around 30,000 electric vehicles. So by 2022 we'll need 10 gigawatt hour, then by 2025 it will become 6 times, and then it will become 12 times by 2030. So as you can see, exponential need is there for batteries in India, and if we don't cultivate this manufacturing facility in our current India right now, then it can be another solar cell manufacturing episode, wherein India didn't give much importance to solar cell manufacturing and China cultivated it a big time and they emerged as a superpower, because solar energy is the new thing and many countries are cultivating it, and that's why China is benefiting the most. And Indian government right now doesn't want to miss this opportunity which of manufacturing our own lithium batteries and exporting it to other countries as well, because this is the future that's going to be there, and given the circumstances, if we have good facilities, most of the countries will prefer us over China. And this shows that we need to make products, and government has taken many initiatives to encourage companies to manufacture lithium ion batteries and electric vehicles in India and exporting it to other countries. So we'll be seeing what all are the initiatives that is taken by government of India. First is GST rates have been reduced from 12% to 5% on electric vehicles. We see normal vehicle GST tax is 28% and electric vehicle is 5%. This is to bring more and more attractiveness towards electric vehicles among the consumers, and this will make the cost of electric vehicles little more affordable and cheaper. Additionally, it's giving an income tax deduction of up to 1.5 lakh rupees on the loans that you have taken to purchase the electric vehicles. So you don't have to pay tax for like 1.5 lakhs if you are paying interest money on the loan that you have used to purchase the electric vehicle. And import duty on lithium cell, that is second stage of manufacturing. If you are importing lithium cells, the import duty will be 10% from April 2021, which was 5% before. So it will become costlier for the companies and also for the consumers. So companies will have to cultivate their own manufacturing facilities and start manufacturing within India. Import duty on completely assembled batteries will be increased to 15% in April 2021, so it's even worse if you are planning to completely import the assembled batteries. So you need to start manufacturing the batteries. And India has a scheme which is known as FAME, that is faster adoption and manufacturing of hybrid and electric vehicles. Under phase 2 of this, government has allocated 10,000 crore till 2022 so that companies can start manufacturing their own batteries, and government will help them financially as well with this 10,000 crore. And also one more major hurdle, that is charging stations. This also they are planning to improve the infrastructure for this. Now you can see petrol bunk wherever you go. Similarly, you should find petrol charging stations if you have electric vehicles. That's why government is concentrating on improving the charging infrastructure as well, and government is giving a lot of importance to this sector. People need to take it up, and more companies have to start involving, and there are many companies that are involved. Let's see, then they are all big players, so let's see about that. Before going there, let's see the reserves of lithium across globe. That is, what country has more lithium? So Chile has 8,000 megaton, and then Australia, then Argentina, and then China. Even though Chile has highest reserves, Australia is largest manufacturer, because Chile is thinking of long term. Because once Australia is out of its lithium reserves, then Chile will become the superpower, and more people will depend on one country and they can control the prices. So this is the basic thinking of that country. And similarly, there are many other countries. So India, we don't have our reserves of our own. So we are depending on other countries for this, and that will be there. As usual, you can't do anything about it, but you can reduce the cost of lithium cell manufacturing by manufacturing it within the country. This is an industry that's going to be $300 billion industry in the next 10 years. That's very rapid growth, and you need to be in this race along with the companies that are in this race, and you should start investing in these companies. And once again, let me tell, these are my opinions. Please contact your stock broker and consult him before investing in any of the companies. First company is Tata Chemical. So it's a Tata company. They have their own Tata Motors, and they are into this sector, and they have entered a non-exclusive MOU, Vikram Sarabhai Space Center of Indian Research, ISRO. So basically, ISRO has the technology, as we saw before, and they have given this technology to many companies, not just Tata Chemicals. They have given it to BHEL, many companies, for 1 crore in exchange. And these companies can use this technology to manufacture their own lithium-ion batteries. Tata Chemicals has made an investment of 40 billion rupees, and it has acquired 126 acres of land in Dholera, that is in Gujarat, to set up their manufacturing plant. Then they are planning to start manufacturing, that is producing 10 gigawatt hour initially, and then 50 gigawatt hour. As we saw, by 2030 we need 120 gigawatt hour. So this capacity and demand cannot be just satisfied by single company. So there are many companies in this that are being playing here. So for sourcing lithium, they are in talks with Bolivia, which is a country that has good reserves of lithium as well. Next is Suzuki. Suzuki is a Japan company, and it's used, as you know, Maruti Suzuki is the biggest player in automobile sector, and they are planning to manufacture their own lithium ion batteries again. And this factory will be built with an investment of $180 million, and their plant is also, again, they are planning to set it up in Gujarat. And they are in tie with Denso, that is one of Toyota's unit, and Toshiba to start production of this lithium ion battery. So no companies have started manufacturing. They are all still in progress, and it will be starting most probably within this year or next year. Due to pandemic, the dates have been delayed. So once they start manufacturing, it's a never-ending process, and they'll keep manufacturing. And it's a sector you should be involved in for huge returns in long term. Next company is BHEL, that is Bharat Heavy Electrical Limited. It's a PSU, and they have got the technology from ISRO, and also they are in talks with one of Australian based company called Nipcoin to start manufacturing these batteries in India. So they are planning to set up 30 gigawatt cores like by 2030. And this is one of the companies that ISRO has entered in MOU with, and just like Tata Chemicals, and there are many other companies in this MOU. Exide India is the next company that is already a leader in battery manufacturing, and they have entered into in a joint venture with Switzerland based Lecklands, and their company name is NextCharge. That is the company that will be manufacturing lithium ion batteries is called as NextCharge. They have a plant in Pranji, and as of now it's 1.5 gigawatt hour, and their chief, one of their officials, told that by July 10th out of this year they'll start manufacturing lithium ion pouch cell batteries in India. But the cells will be imported from Germany's Lecklands plant until they can manufacture within the country. So I feel that deadline is most probably April 2021, because import rates are going to be higher. So by then, the companies will have to set up their own facilities if they want to make these cars cheaper and if they want to stay competitive in this space. Then again, Amar Raja Batteries, they are second biggest player in battery segment, and they are also setting up a plant, and they are also tying up with many foreign people, and they are planning to grab major share. Next, if you look at other companies that are involved, we have Adani, Hero Motocorp, Mahindra and Hyundai. As you can see, all are big players that are involved in this game. It's a very neck-to-neck race, and the first mover here has an advantage, and when the companies have so much advantage, even the investors have advantage. So I recommend you guys to invest in this sector, and please look out for any new news that will be coming. So to sum it up, it's a wait and watch. First mover has advantage, and keep an eye out for these stocks. And even if you don't keep an eye out, please subscribe to my channel and also join my Telegram channel. The link is there in bio, so that I'll be updating there more and more about this sector, on any sector, and I'll be giving stock suggestions and other news which I'll be coming across, which will be valuable to you guys. So please consider joining those channels and subscribe to my channel and share it with your friends so that everyone, let them know that how to invest in sector that's going to become a next big thing and how to get huge returns from them in the long run. So please subscribe to my channel, join my Telegram channel for more and more updates, so that even if you miss out, I'll update you guys there so that you don't miss out and don't be a late starter in this race. So thank you, and I'll be coming with more and more videos. If you have any particular video that you want me to work on, please type it in comment section below and let me know. And thank you once again.